So, because he hasn't gotten into the room, but he has had every news, every story. And then he refused to go inside the house. He said, why would my dad do that? Look at me, I've been here, I've been obedient, I'm in church. I'm every time I'm in church, I'm doing this and I'm doing that. You know, that's kind of one thing that happened in the church. When someone falls as a Christian and goes down there and hit the rock bottom and comes back to church, the senior brother syndrome seems to take over to those who have been in church, those who have not fallen, those who have not done this and not done that, but they were in church doing everything they're supposed to do. It's kind of hard for them to forgive. But the only way we can forgive is you can apply the agape law. Amen?
Amen.
Notwithstanding we are in church, we are doing everything we are doing. There are times we are forgiving, we have sinned against God. St. John 1:8 says, if anyone says you have not sinned, you are making God a liar. Isn't it? You are making God a liar. But if we confess our sins and repent from them and confess it, God is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. God will forgive us and wash us clean, qualify us again to come to his presence. And as we have received that very forgiveness, we are called upon to give it out to the people around us. Amen.
Amen.
So, in conclusion this morning, brothers and sisters, the eldest brother missed the point. He missed the point because he was looking at what the brother has lost. He was looking at all the money he carried out from the family. He went down there and squandered it. But he was not seeing it from his father's perspective. He was not seeing it that my brother has come back now. I think what he lost can be replaced. But if he has been lost, there's no way we can be able to replace him. You see how we think to be able to apply what God tells us to do. And so that's what actually really happened. So here God calls us to a lifestyle of agape love. Amen?
Amen.
A lifestyle of agape love that we can extend forgiveness, divine forgiveness to those who have wronged us and pray for their well-being and give as we sow into the lives of people. Show forth that you yourself have been forgiven. And as you know you are forgiven, you give out that forgiveness to your brothers and to your sisters and to your children that have erred and to your husband that have hurt you and to your wife that has broken your heart. You can do that. And if you do that, God knows that you are extending agape because of him, and he shall in turn bless you. Let us pray. This is my prayer. Shall we all stand praying to the King?